Welcome to Advith DevOps World. Now let's understand what is DevOps. So before we talk about DevOps, let's see a simple cycle story. If you see this cycle, there are majorly two wheels. If these two wheels runs smoothly, only then we can reach the destination very quickly. Yes or no? Remember this principle. If only these two wheels runs very smoothly, only then we can reach the destination very quickly. Okay, right. Now let's move on. Agenda. My agenda of this session is to explain about basic idea about DevOps, DevOps roles and responsibilities, DevOps tools, CI/CD flow, benefits of DevOps, and common doubts. Now let's see what is DevOps. DevOps is a practice. DevOps is a practice which helps to integrate developers and operations to improve the productivity by automating infrastructure activities. Okay, DevOps is not a language. DevOps is not a tool. It's not a methodology. It is a practice which helps to integrate the developers and operations to improve the productivity by automating infrastructure activities. This is the principle. DevOps, development and operations. Okay, so compare this one with the previous cycle map here. Development. Okay, when these two runs smoothly, only then we can reach the destination very quickly, right? Same way here, development and operations, only these two wheels runs smoothly, we can deliver the product very quickly. Okay, right. Now let's see our day-to-day activities for development and operation. For development, in general they will use languages like Java, .NET, Python, PHP, and their day-to-day activities is to develop the code, implement some modules and fix it, or production support. Okay, so something which is related to the coding related, right? And let's see the operations. Okay, operations are nothing but, right, other than this development. Okay, remaining everything comes under operations, like right from the source code management and compilation, build management, packaging, right, and deployment and release management, right, how to execute, right, and CI/CD, continuous integration and continuous deployment, and environment provisioning, right, so to maintain your environment, installing something, uninstalling something, right, or installing some services, right, uninstalling some services, users creation, deletion, config files updation, right. So other than this development activities, okay, whichever the activity we might need to support, okay, we might need to execute to run our project, right? So these are all called as operations. Okay, so these operations are going to be automated using the DevOps. Okay, these are the operations. Okay, right. Now what are the tools are required, right? What are the tools are needed to automate these operations, right? DevOps has brought multiple set of tools under single umbrella, which helps us to automate our complete set of operations. Okay, DevOps is not just a single tool, or it's not just a collection of five tools, or not just a collection of some tools. It's a collection of multiple tools and multiple subset of processes again, right? So now let's move on and understand each subset here, right? Version management. Version management is nothing but it helps to track, control the source code changes and also enables the parallel development. This version management process helps you to manage your source code. Okay, if you can see this picture, each file has set of versions. So when you were maintaining each version of the file, it is easy for you to roll back your changes. Okay, so that indirectly enables the reproducibility, and also it also enables the parallel development. Okay, so if you can see this is a centralized repository for the project, and these are all the feature branches, and everybody works on the feature branch, and from the feature branch they will also merge the changes to the main branch, that is master, right? So to enable this in future, in your project, we need set of tools like either CVS, ClearCase, SVN, Gate, GitHub, Mercurial, or Perforce. There are several tools in the market, okay, to enable your to enable the version management in the project. And build and repository management. Build is nothing but, what is a build? Build is nothing but transforming the source code into binaries, right? So we are able to manage the source code here, right? It is star.java file. So what's next? Okay, we need compilation and packaging. So that can be automated using build management. Build is nothing but transforming your source code into binaries, is called as build. Build management responsibility is to set up the build environment and day-to-day build activities and build automation. If you can see this here, for the build, input is your start Java code, and compile is nothing but your build, and output here is going to be binary file. It can be .lass file or DLL file, okay? Or finally, we'll get the output, like after packaging, we'll get that packages are like jar, var, er. These packages are also called as artifacts. These packages are also called as artifacts. To automate this complete process, okay, there are several tools like for Java, Ant, Maven, Gradle, etc. And .NET, NAND, and MSBuild. For C or C++, Make is a build tool. Repository management. Now, what is repository management? It helps you to manage storage your artifacts. Okay, what is the artifact? The output of this build. These are all, we are getting these artifacts, right? Where can we store all these artifacts, right? We can store all these artifacts into single location. That's called repository management. Okay, right. And release management. Release management, before we talk about release, let's understand deployment. Deployment is nothing but executing the application in one environment, is called deployment. Release. Release is nothing but deploying the changes in the production, that is live environment. Promoting your changes into the live is called as release. Okay, then what's the responsibility of release management? Release management is to plan, track, coordinate the team for all the releases. Okay, so for deploying here, deployment tools are like for Java, Tomcat, JBoss, WebLogic, WebSphere. There are several servers where we can deploy our application and run your application. For .NET, IIS is a server to run your application. Okay, and CI/CD, this is one of the important concept we should definitely understand here, right? So continuous integration, it's a continuous process of integrating all the changes and run the build, and then run unit testing and packaging binaries. Okay, so it's a continuation process. As soon as the developer checks the code in the version management tool, this CI/CD will trigger the build automatically, and it will also run the unit testing, and finally it will also generate the packages. This complete process is called as continuous integration. Okay, what are the tools helps us to implement continuous integration? Jenkins, Hudson, TeamCity, Cruise Control, Bamboo. These are the very famous tools in the market to implement our continuous integration. Continuous deployment. Continuous deployment is nothing but automating your deployment activities, okay, across all the environments, is called as continuous deployment. So tools are like Rundeck, Udeploy, Nolio, Deployment Manager, Joulu, and like this. There are several tools in the market to implement continuous deployment. Let's see what is CI/CD flow. The basic CI/CD flow seems to be like this. Okay, the developer will go for the review, internal review, and then they will push the changes to version management tool, okay, or SVN and Git. It can be any other tool. Okay, as soon as they push the changes here, our continuous integration tool identifies the change and triggers the build and triggers the unit testing and generates the packaging, okay, as soon as developer push the changes to version control tool. Okay, this is an automatic process. Okay, so it happens continuously. He will push the code, it will run the build, and it will run the unit test casing, and it will also generate the package, and finally it will send the notification. Okay, and once the build is success, it will generate the artifact. Those artifacts will be uploaded into artifact repository. Okay, if build fails, okay, it will not generate any artifact, then it will just send the email notification to the user. And CD, continuous deployment is nothing but this tool helps you to automate your deployment activities across all the environment. That's called as continuous deployment. This is called as continuous deployment, right? And cloud and monitoring. Okay, cloud technology, right? So this cloud helps you to create virtual infrastructure, right? So instead of spending time for creating our own data center, time for investing a lot of money at a time for implementing this data center and thing, no, just within few minutes using this cloud technology, just within few minutes we can create hundreds of servers. We can run the application within the minutes, right, using this cloud technology. And monitoring is one of the important concept here, which monitoring enables to monitor all your servers health and applications operations, right? So your application used to get some transactions from the end users and do the operations, right? So who is monitoring this, whether this application module is up and running, whether how, what is the health of this, right? So this all can be automated using monitoring tool. Like tools are like for monitoring tools like Nagios, Datalog, Kibana, all these tools. And for cloud technologies like AWS, Azure, Google, Rackspace, and OpenShift, IBM Cloud, there are several clouds, okay, different clouds are there, okay. Right, configuration management. Okay, so this is one of the very, very important concept. It helps to turn infrastructure into code. Okay, this also called as infra as a code. Okay, so this helps to enable the server management. Okay, when you have hundreds of servers in your organization, right, if you take example Google has minimum 10,000 servers, right? How can you install some software in 10,000 servers? How can you manage all these servers, right? To manage all these servers, we need this kind of configuration management tool. Okay, tools are like Chef, Puppet, Ansible, SaltStack, Terraform, Vagrant, okay, Blade Logic, like this. Several Chef configuration management tools are available in the market. Other automations like testing automation, run the test cases, okay, test execution automatically, right? So to enable this automation testing, we have tools like Selenium, Cucumber, JUnit, TestNG, like this. Okay, so and then logging. Okay, so logging means recording all your transaction. Okay, enables the logging feature for different servers to track and troubleshoot, and also enables the alerting mechanism. Okay, it is not just recording, it will also send the alerts as soon as some transaction goes wrong, as soon as some transaction got stuck up, then it will also send the alerts. Okay, so using Splunk, Logstash, like these kind of tools, we can enable the logging feature in our application, right? So benefits of DevOps, right? So using this DevOps, what are the benefits, right? So better collaboration between all your teams, right? Better quality, right? So definitely using all these tools, all these operations automation, we can give the better quality for the customer. Quick deliverables, right? This is one of the important features for DevOps, right? Quick deliverables. We can deliver the product as quickly as possible. We can enable the agility in our project. Okay, enables the communication between the team. Yes, of course, it brings everybody into the closure, right? So enables everybody to interact each other and get the work done as quickly as possible. More responsive to business. Okay, it helps a lot for the business to release the features as quickly as possible. Focus on business need, right? So when you have the DevOps in your place, right, you just need to focus on your business. You don't need to worry about infrastructure or your delivery, right? So just need to concentrate on business needs. Faster time to market, right? It is very faster to deliver the features into the market, okay, to deliver your project into the market, right? And so now let's read the DevOps abbreviation again. Okay, now let's read it again. DevOps is a practice. What is DevOps? DevOps is a practice which helps to integrate developers and operations to improve the productivity by automating infrastructure activities. This DevOps is helping us to automate all these infrastructure operations. Okay, all these infrastructure operations. This indirectly, what it is helping? Okay, so it is helping us to deliver the product as quickly as possible. Okay, that is called DevOps. It's a practice. Okay, right now, let's see Commom Doubts, right? So is scripting mandatory to work as a DevOps engineer? No, it is not mandatory. If you have the scripting knowledge, that is well and good, that is the added value. Do we need to learn all these tools? Okay, nobody knows all these tools, remember? Okay, so it is not mandatory to learn all the tools. Okay, I suggest you to learn at least one tool from each subset of these tools. That means at least one tool from version management, one tool from CI, one tool from build management, like that. Okay, right. And do I need to complete any external certifications? Okay, it is not mandatory. If you can do that, that is well and good. It's again added value for your resume. Which tools I need to learn? Okay, so tools, as I said, at least one tool from each subset, and also focus on the tools, like which are the tools being used in your project. Okay, focus that on the tools which are being used in your project. Is this job is safe? Definitely. Okay, compared to all other jobs, okay, DevOps is more safer, and it's going to be future for minimum 5 to 10 years. Okay, how much package I can get? Okay, definitely it is better salary compared to all other fields. Okay, does all the projects uses the same set of tools? No. Okay, so one project might use some set of tools. Okay, so in this subset of tools, okay, one project might use only version management, CI and CD. Another project might use only release management, monitoring and debugging. Or some other project might use all the subset of tools. Okay, it is not mandated to use all these tools in your project. Okay, right. And does every project implement the DevOps? Okay, so as per the 2017 statistics, okay, 45 to 50% of the projects have been implemented this DevOps. Okay, so definitely, okay, so we will definitely see a rapid change in the coming years. Okay, so when this percentage gets increased to 60 to 70 in coming year, definitely we'll be having a lot of demand for the DevOps engineers, right? So everybody is realizing the DevOps value now. Okay, so that's the reason rapidly everybody adopting this DevOps practices into their project. Okay, do I need to know SDLC and Agile? So these are the practice for, especially when you enter into the IT, okay, it is mandatory to get some idea about SDLC and Agile framework, right? All these DevOps tools are open source? No. Okay, all these tools are not open source. Okay, few are open source, few are commercial. Okay, so these are the common doubts I want to answer through this video. Okay, so thank you for watching. Please share your valuable feedback. Thank you. Welcome to Advith DevOps World again. Thank you so much.